Hey, good day. I'm Mark Groen. I'm the market development agronomist in Ottawa and surrounding area. I'm out in Renfrew today. I'm taking a look at some of our newer products. Just checking out one of our plots today, looking at some of the new 3537. So this is a new one in the seed guide. This is it here today in the field. So it's a very solid looking product, fairly girthy ear on it. Something that we notice fairly consistently with this product is not a whole lot of tip dieback on it. When you put this one in the medium, in the higher fertility ground, you push the population, it is going to respond. If the populations are a little bit lower, it is going to flex in length. It's a really nice looking and consistent product in different environments. So really like the look of it so far. Nice girthy cob on it. Right next to it, we got our 3457. This has been another solid product for us. As far as rounds, often somewhat comparable to the 3537 based on what we're seeing so far. Tends to have a little bit more tip die back, and we know that this one has a high top end yield. And we'll be taking this off for harvest, but so far really liking the look of this new 3537. So this is 3537, incredibly consistent product here. You know, it really stood out in plots last year as being a consistent product. Lots of flex and cob length potential for this one. Tends to be very consistent with its rounds as well. It's a product that we're really, really excited about. Obviously, in addition to a great looking cob here, fantastic stocks on this product. Excellent, excellent yield potential on it. A little bit lighter than something like our 3588, but we know that 3588 dries down fast, has a super heavy test weight. As far as pushing the yield potential, as far as pushing the envelope on yield, this is an excellent product for doing that. Very solid.